Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Sydney's Opera House, 5th season, 3rd show. We're here live from Australia. One more week, and guess what? We're just 2 weeks away from our next pay-per-view, named after Right to Uncensor. And feuds have been going wild in the last couple of weeks. Tonight we have a huge main event. We're gonna have Chapa João Silva facing none other than Billy Ray Diggler. And I really can tell you that this match has a high quality. He even has a pay-per-view quality, just like I was telling my broadcast colleague here. But now let's move ahead with the show. Wait, wait a minute. What the hell is that? Is this the way this show is gonna start tonight? Look at that in the middle of the crowd. Middle of the crowd, Jacqueline and Sable are in a brawl fight here tonight. Look at that in the middle of the crowd. What the hell is this? Jacqueline and Sable. We saw the warning last week by Jacqueline to Sable, and this is, well, the road to their match at Right to Uncensor. Look at that! Jacqueline clothesline Sable into the barricade. Now we are near the ring, moving out of the crowd. Now they are going towards the backstage area. The brawl fight continues. And now they are fighting on backstage. Look at that. Nobody can separate these two. Jacqueline and Sable. What a massive brawl here to fight this thing off. Start this thing off tonight. And as soon as we see this brawl on backstage, Tyson Kidd is passing through them. What the hell? Tyson Kidd is not gonna say them thing or try to separate them both. This shows you what kind of bastard our general manager is right now. This guy really has changed his attitude towards this business. And now he passes the backstage and he's coming down the aisle to the ring while this attack happens on backstage. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I guess we have some kind of a fight brawl on backstage. But that won't mean a thing to me, because tonight I have something far way more serious to take care of. And now it seems like it is a double challenge, because not only this thing has happened with Schleck and Billy and now Bruce Bannister. It seems like Billy has returned tonight. And this hit between me, Schleck, and Bruce Bannister, alongside with my friend BG Golan, is not the only thing that is bothering me at this moment time. Because earlier tonight, it seems like that broadcast guy right there that I have contracted, Jim McElwit, has told me about some rumors that are going on at this moment on our network. Yeah! Now, these rumors, I hope they are a lie, because they don't seem to quite impress me, so to say. So, Jim McElwit, I ask you please, for a minute, come out of that broadcast table and tell me right there in this ring, in front of this crowd, that the thing you told me is nothing more than just a rumor. Tell me that. Come on. Well, my colleague here, Jim McElwit, is going into the ring now, and I still don't know what the hell Tyson Kidd is talking about. I hope Jim explains himself. Sorry to tell you, boss, but actually, it was not just a rumor. In fact, the network is announcing that next week we're gonna start having our last 10 to 15 minutes of our show dedicated to a new brand named after Ringside Wrestling. And it is gonna work as both a normal brand and a new talent development center. So no, it is not just a rumor, boss, it is a fact. No, this is not happening. This is not happening. Tell me that this is a lie. After all of the crap that I have to deal with, those guys in the back, Schleck, Bruce Bannister, now I have to deal with this? What the hell is going on here? Well, that's what the network told me. That's what the network told you, Jim. And now tell me one more thing that I don't seem to understand here. They didn't even contact me to make this decision. And to top it off, well, how does this network comes around with a new brand, insert it on my show, and they don't even tell me anything about it? And to top it off, I don't even know who are the owners of that brand, that you so-called Ringside Wrestling. And this is all happening in my show. This is my show. This is not your show, Jim. This is not this fan's show. This is not the network show. This is my show. Yeah, you're right, Tyson, but the network, it broadcasts your show. So they have an amount of power over your show as well, because they are favoring you with a network deal. Shut up, Jim McCallot. I don't need your moral instructions. I am mad at this enough. Oh, wait, Jim, just wait. You must know who are the owners of that brand. You must know who are the owners. So tell me, before I lose my mind right now, tell me. Who has the audacity to run a new brand on my show under the network's umbrella without telling me? Tell me who are the owners of that new brand. I don't know. This is all I know, Tyson. I just know that there is a new brand taking 10 to 15 minutes of your show. Besides that, I don't know anything else. I don't know the wrestlers. I don't know the owners. I don't know what type of deal they made with the network. Nothing else. Oh, you don't know nothing else. All right. So I'm gonna get out of here and try to figure it out, something in the backstage, because it seems like I'm always the last one to know about this type of things, which doesn't make sense consider that this is my show. But I'm gonna go to the back and find out what's going on here. Oh, wait a minute, here he comes. That's Bruce Bannister coming down the aisle and now giving a chair shot to Tyson Kidd. Look at that. Oh my goodness, this thing continues now, and now Tyson is getting out of the ring. Hey, well, that's not just Bruce Bannister, that's Schleck as well. Look at Schleck behind Tyson Kidd's back. Oh my goodness, look behind you, Tyson, look in the back. Oh my. Now Tyson is getting out of the arena now. He's getting out of the stage. Hey, you Schleck, what the hell are you doing here? Take him out of the arena. He was banned last week. He doesn't belong here. Securities chase after him. And now securities are running after Schleck into the backstage arena. And what a way to start this thing off tonight. This is getting serious. Week after week, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, what the hell? What else is gonna happen here tonight? I don't know. The fact is that you never know what to expect from a company like this. Each and every single week, this is unpredictable as fuck now. Let's move ahead with this. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're back here in PWC, and on the back we're seeing Gabriel walking around. What the hell is that? Isn't that too cold, Scorpio? Don't you tell me that this guy is chasing after me. Let me see. Where the hell is he? He was there. There? Who? Who was there? Too Cold Scorpio was there. I saw him chasing after me. Come on, Gabriel. There is nobody here. How can you tell me there is nobody? He was there. He must have disappeared. Disappeared how? There is nobody here. I was just getting in here to make an interview with you, Gabriel, and I didn't see any Too Cold Scorpio around the area. I don't want any damn interview. I know what I saw. He must be somewhere, and I'm gonna find him. Whatever the place, he has hidden himself. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're back in the broadcast table, and is Gabriel having some illusions or some visions around his eyes? I mean, he said he saw Too Cold Scorpio, but he was not anywhere to be found near him. So did he actually see Too Cold Scorpio, or was it just a vision? Well, I don't know. This cult are very, very peculiar types of persons, and sometimes I don't understand their behaviors. It must have been too cold, or must have not been too cold. I guess we're gonna find out later tonight, as soon as this show continues.
Superstars appear to be in here tonight. I fully expect to see one of the most competitive matches we've seen in a very long time.
Allow me to point out just how focused he appears to be here tonight.
I noticed the same thing, Cole. In fact, looks to me like he'll settle for nothing short of a victory here in this one.
Most exciting superstars ready to square off here.
And there's nothing quite like seeing two superstars settling it in the ring in one-on-one action, Michael.
Hey, guys, you can bet there are plenty of superstars in the back crowded around the monitor for this one.
Yeah, this really is an intriguing matchup, Cole, and the end result can very well trigger a domino effect on the rest of the roster.
And we're underway. Looking at these two men, I don't think there's going to be anything traditional about this one-on-one matchup.
Here we go, fellas. I've been looking forward to this one for quite some time.
Guys, Cincinnati is in for a treat. This is going to be one heck of a match. He delivers a crushing neckbreaker. He misses the dive.
And unfortunately for him, there was no water in the pool.
And there's a bone-crunching drop. And he slams him down. What a display of unmitigated strength. Look at him catch him off guard, and he kicks out.
That's either sheer genius or complete stupidity, Cole.
He's not looking like himself here. With these two guys, we all knew this was going to be an all-out battle.
This one could very easily go either way at this point, guys. But win or lose, he's the type of guy that will be proud of his performance regardless.
Looks like Knight's starting to sweat here. But he's very aware of who he's in there with and what he has to do to rebound.
Hey, you're going to absorb some punishment in a wrestling match. It just goes along with the territory, and he knows that. I doubt he's all that concerned at this point.
I don't know about you guys, but I find it hard not to root for him. How could you not like a guy as trustworthy and dependable as him?
He gets him with a reversal. Look out below. Now that one well scouted. This is what makes him one of the best in the business. He's calling for it. He's looking at it. Did you see that?
Truly devastating, Cole.
Look at this. Nicely executed.
Can't waste any time here.
Looking at it here. Wait a minute. He's pressing all the right buttons now. Dropped by a clothesline. And he goes down hard.
Yeah, and I think he might have slipped a little too.
What?
I don't know, guys. I really thought we would have seen the finisher already.
no stopping him now.
He's not getting up. You can't like his chances right now. Just in reach of the rope.
Not sure why he would go for the submission so close to the ropes. Definitely not the best strategy I've ever seen.
He has him right where he wants him.
If he sticks this, he is done.
Momentum's firmly in his corner now.
That should do it.
This should do it right there.
Just a matter of time now before this superstar goes for the finisher. And when that happens, you can bet this one's over.
He is a one-man gang in there.
Keep your eye on this one. Not where he wants to be right now.
Yeah, you're not going to win many matches when you're down.
Lands this, and he is done.
Not going to go quietly.
No superstar worth his salt ever does.
And he lands a nice counter. The unfortunate reality is he might not get up,
which wouldn't shock me one bit. Talk about a beating he's taken here tonight.
Hurricane Rana, and nobody does it better. That'll knock the wind right out of you. Here he comes. He's moving with confidence now, guys.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other. Oh no, he's taken down.
You know, I don't think he has much left.
There's the cover. Can he do it? And you could put this singles match in the books.
Both men enter this match with tidal waves of momentum, which set them on a collision course for this very moment. It's all or nothing, and these two men wouldn't have it any other way.
These guys are undoubtedly going to give us a show here tonight.
Rightfully so. Bowling Green has been buzzing ever since this match was announced. Devastating DDT. Oh man, right on the top of the head. That strike hit the spot. There's no way he could have avoided that blow. Look at this. This guy can go toe-to-toe with anybody. He caught him slipping.
He's sending a message to the entire WWE locker room here. Spear!
That was vicious.
Now that's what I call making a statement.
Ah, close to getting a count out here.
Nah, this is just some strategic gamesmanship.
So much power behind that punch.
Just making his presence felt there.
Stops him with a DDT. He's taking a long time to get up, guys.
Perhaps playing a little possum here, Cole.
Getting from the floor. Got the reversal. Not sure he has enough gas left in the tank, but he's looking to answer the call. Oh no, a counter! A head-pounding bulldog!
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
He might have it.
He goes for it all.
Game, set, match. This one is over.
This could be it for him, guys.
Yeah, he's on Dream Street.
Looking for the finish. Here he goes. What a driver.
That has got to be it.
He looks for it once again. Driver!
That should do it.
That'll knock you silly, that's for sure.
One, two. That's it. Wait, only two! Oh, I don't think he got the shoulder up in time.
He needs to change something fast, guys.
He's showing some major resiliency here.
Or lunacy, depending on how you want to look at it.
And the splash finds its mark.
Ill-advised move.
And there's the sidewalk slam, sending the opponent back first into the mat.
He misses the mark.
He might need glasses, Cole. His eyesight is clearly compromised.
He lands the overhand. Down he goes.
That'll do it every time.
What's gonna happen? This match could go anywhere.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
He clearly did his homework heading into tonight.
He's starting to show signs of fatigue. He's gonna want to make sure this doesn't snowball out of control.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves, Cole. This is just a little
bear.
Wow, I'm just as surprised as you guys are. Oh boy, he is rolling.
This might be the end of the road for him, Byron.
Well, if he can't get back to his feet, you're absolutely right.
This one's for good measure. His signature slam.
Just when you thought he had nothing left.
He may get the three count right there.
One, two, three.
It's over. It's over. Can you believe it? It's all over.
Dead man walking.
Keep rolling, 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 rolling. 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 Hands up, hands up. Don't be watching, brother. Don't let it rain.
Here is your winner, Dawn Tornado.
That's an impressive win right there.
That's a big win right there. Anytime you can pin another WWE competitor's shoulders to the mat for the three count, you should be proud.
As we close the book on this match, I need to remind everybody just how big of a win this was. Simply amazing.
Well, we've got to admit, you pulled out a better effort than we initially expected. We'd even go as far as to say we're impressed. But you can't really make amends with the dark. That's right, Don. We understand the cult wants to make a war out of this. So, gentlemen, thy wish is our command. And if it's a war that you want, then it's a war you're going to get. But don't lay your heads to rest yet. Because the other battles to come will be even tougher. So take everything that you've accomplished. Bring your titles and your allies. Our cause is ready. And now that we've unsettled your minds with our little stunt last week, you know as well as we do, we've got you on the ropes. And now the lights are starting to flicker. The environment is getting cold here. The lights are out. We can see anything. And now look at the Titantron. The cult, who just a couple of minutes ago had two grueling matches against the Motorcycle Gangsters in an individual basis, have just appeared on the screen out of nowhere. This can't get even worse, can it? Illusion. Pretty much everyone has it, and no one can stay away from it. Last week, you kidnapped Lilith. This week, you wanted to test me and my brethren. And I'm a reasonable man. I'll give you credit where credit's due. You passed that test. But there's still one piece of the puzzle that you must try to eradicate. Oh my God! Abaddon is back, and as it seems, she is still a part of the cult. Now Abaddon has been out for months nursing minor injuries, but now she's back with the cult. Hello, cruel world. Mommy's home. Last week, you kidnapped me. And you just got lucky that I didn't feast on all of that flesh. But since my brethren were so positively impressed by your efforts, I'm gonna save you the sacrifice for now. Tonight, you beat Artur and Solanter. So they have decided to give you 1 week to choose an opponent, and that said opponent will step up next week to face my sister, Abaddon. Good luck. You're gonna need it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back here in PWC, and as you can see on the backstage, there is a cop's car, and guess who's inside of it? Someone is inside of that cop's car. Well, I cannot believe this. The securities finally have got Schleck. They have chased after him into the backstage. And now it seems like he's going to the jail. And I'm receiving here word. No, that's in fact, that is Schleck there. Receiving here word by Tyson Kidd that in those next two weeks that Schleck was banned, he's gonna spend those 2 weeks in jail just to make sure everything is protected around PWC's arena in Sydney's Opera House.
Arena for this one is absolutely insane, guys.
And if you think this is insane, just wait until this thing kicks into high gear. You ain't seen nothing yet.
This is the match we've all been waiting for.
And the electricity level in the arena right now is unlike anything I've ever felt.
Participants, this match might very well steal the show, guys.
Yeah, and I think you could go so far as to say it has the makings of a match of the year candidate.
Legal men are in the ring and set to start things off here. We're ready to go.
Guys, the tag team scene in WWE right now is so impressive, and these two tandems are a lot of the reason why.
Guys, Bowling Green better be ready because this match will be like no other. hits him with a face buster.
As the action continues, let's discuss White briefly. In a tag team, being a good partner is as important as anything else. How can he do his part tonight in this one?
I know a little something about tag teams, and I think this one's set to be one of the best in WWE.
Now he finds himself in this match on a team that looks primed and ready to win. But there are two other individuals who feel the same way. Prepare to witness an incredible clash.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
He hits the clothesline.
Ortiz looking a little frustrated.
This tag team match is dangerously close to getting out of control for him.
I don't know, he just seems a little intimidated from the start. And I don't remember ever seeing him look that way.
There's the leg lock. Got all that neck breaker.
Nowhere to go for Ortiz.
Unless this thing turns around here, this tag team match is all but over.
If he could just make it to his corner, these guys still have a chance. But if not, I don't see how he can overcome all this punishment and win.
I think I can safely speak for all of us when I say that this beating he's taking is pretty tough to watch.
Nope, reverses it. Well executed drop kick. Uh-oh, he's in trouble here.
He wants no part of this.
White slipping some here.
And you have to assume his partner is just itching to get in there right about now.
The beauty of tag team competition is that he doesn't need to take the entire
neck breaker.
This could be the turning point, Cole.
So damaging. He's moving like a man possessed. He lands an amazing flip.
There it is.
His shoulders are down.
And he stops the count.
Lucky him.
And he lands a savage elbow.
He gets him with a reversal.
Definitely not where you want to be right now.
He's got to find a way to get out of this, Michael.
White may be fading away here.
He needs to find a way to create some space or else this thing's over.
He's running on fumes right now. It might be smart for him to make a tag. You'd have to think his partner has a little more gas in the tank.
Win or lose, he always seems to have so much pride in what he can do inside that ring. Unfortunately for him, though, it looks like he's going to have to look extra hard for something to feel good about here.
Showing off some of his speed there. Look out, there he goes.
Knocked right off his feet.
Incredible!
Not where he wants to be right now.
Yeah, you're not going to win many matches when you're down.
Three. He's in trouble.
He can't withstand one bit more.
Look at this. He wants no part of the outside. Nope, that one misses.
Boy, that was terrible.
He's pressing all the right buttons now. When this guy's on, look out. And we're back to this form of attack. Desperately needs to make a tag here.
I don't know, it's gonna be tough to make it to the corner.
He's delivering an old-fashioned butt kicking right here. Faria comes in off the tag.
That's a great example of teamwork right there.
And the face buster takes him down. Needs to make it to the corner. And he tags his partner in.
Momentum has certainly shifted here, Michael. He is a one-man gang in there.
A clubbing clothesline. Looking for the win. Warm up the buses. This one's over.
It's heating up now.
He's fighting back here.
I expected nothing less, Cole.
Lightning fast reflexes. Oh, he's able to reverse it. His clothesline finds the mark. Drop hits. Made him pay there.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
White slipping some here.
This tag team match can get out of hand quickly if he doesn't mount an offense soon.
It's decision time, Cole. Does he try to get back on the offensive himself, or does he attempt to make a tag here?
Well, he's definitely become known for his perseverance. Not that he's necessarily going to need it here tonight. He's definitely cruising here.
Another great tag team match here tonight. I don't think the tag team's seen it.
Can he end it quickly?
He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen him in.
He looks for it once again.
That's how you move up the ladder here in WWE.
Wow, I'm just as surprised as you guys are.
Bold move going for it again.
In comes White.
Teamwork at its best.
Will he be victorious? Flips the script on him there. Knocked off his feet.
Now that's a takedown.
Taking him a while to get up here.
I don't think he has anything left, Michael.
Absolutely has to. There it is. The tag has been made.
Oh, he needed that in the worst way, Michael.
He has him right where he wants him.
Coming up big on that one.
Here's his moment, Michael.
No, he releases the hold.
What in the world is he thinking? Does he not want to win?
He thinks he has it.
One, 2, 3. They did it. They won the match.
Here are your winners, Joe White and John White.
Big win here in tag team action tonight.
With wins like that, there's no way these two should even think about splitting up. Just my opinion.
Folks, you're just tuning in.
I'm gonna cut right to the chase because I don't know if my mind can hold on much longer without starting to go mad at myself. Last week, I came out here to defend my hardcore championship and someone stole it away out of its rightful grasp. Last week, Cactus Jack came out here wanting to deliver one more throwback for all these people, but instead, someone decided to unsettle his mind a little more, to the point that his face can only be covered with leather, and that no one can see how much he enjoys distributing pain. Yay! Darby Allin, I know the reason why you interfered. It's because you wanted to prove to me and all these good people that you're as mad and as twisted as I am. But guess what, kid? Twistedness isn't something that's put up for show weekly. Twistedness is simply put a way of life. And now, you're forcing my hand. You're making me go back to a place that I don't want to be. But sometimes, kid, there are actions that reach the point of no return. And you're about to find out that that point has been reached. And I can't be held responsible for most of them. Have a nice day!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're back here in PWC, and once again we're seeing Gabriel on backstage is still trying to search for Too Cold Scorpio, who he said he has found earlier tonight, but when he got there, Too Cold Scorpio was nowhere to be found. He denied his interview with Joseph. Ah, that's him, he's there. I got you, Too Cold. Now you're gonna have the bit of your life. Hey, where the hell is he? Can I now make an interview with you, Gabriel? Joseph, Too Cold Scorpio was there. You saw it, right? I didn't see Too Cold Scorpio. You again with that. Too Cold Scorpio is not here. I think you're delusional or what? There is no Too Cold Scorpio here. You can see it. He was there, Joseph. I saw him with my own eyes for the second time tonight. Well, if you actually saw him, it seems like you're the only one who is seeing someone like Too Cold Scorpio. Because nobody else has seen him tonight. Well, I believe that Gabriel is really actually getting kind of delusional here. We saw this on backstage for the second time tonight. Gabriel is getting paranoid about Too Cold Scorpio chasing after him. But when he gets to the place, he's never there. What the hell has this guy been smoke?
Here is your winner, Finn Gada!
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back here in PWC and it's time to put the cameras on back because Tyson Kidd is on his office door about to get in there, but BG Golão has arrived. Tyson, sorry for asking you this, but who the hell are these guys? Well, they are my securities. Securities? But for what? I mean, isn't Schlack in jail already? Yes, he is, and so what? Well, with all due respect, boss, but if he's in jail, I think it is logic that he's not a come down here. So why do you need these securities for? Listen, BG, I know this, but with Schlack, you never know what to expect. Imagine him escaping the jail and coming back to invade this arena and attack me once again. Oh, and by the way, it can attack you as well. Have you forgotten about the fact that you and him have a hit over the world title at Right to Uncensor? Well, I didn't, Tyson, thanks to remind me. But isn't this going too far? You don't need these securities for anything. He's on jail. So tell me, how can he escape jail and come down here? There is no way that is happening, Tyson. You never know what to expect. Hey, Tyson, come back here. Man, you're getting paranoid about Schlag. You don't need these securities for nothing. Come on, Tyson. Well, we're back here in the broadcast table and, well, in fact, BG is right. How can that man get out of a jail? It is almost impossible. Well, it is almost impossible, but it is not impossible coming from someone like Schlack. So it wouldn't be a surprise for me if next week we come back and Schlack is still around the arena for some whatever reason. Now let's move ahead with the show. It's time for one more match coming your way. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're back in PWC and what a night this has been. But it seems like something is going on backstage. Gabriel, oh no, don't you tell me that. Gabriel is still looking for Too Cold Scorpio. And man, this guy is, what the hell? Joseph is not even trying to get there anymore. And hey, what the hell? That is Too Cold Scorpio attacking Gabriel from the back. Well, actually, Gabriel was right. Too Cold was just hiding himself. Look at that. Look at that. Too Cold Scorpio attacking Gabriel on backstage. And even the cameraman is being hitten by Too Cold by accident. He has fallen down. And now the cameras are catching this match in a very bad angle, but we still can see what's going on here. Now the referee is trying to separate them. Stop with this, stop with this! And they are getting back to the fight even after being separated. Stop with this! Stop it! Hey, stop it! I am sick of this. What the hell? The referee is getting involved in between these two. The referee was trying to separate them. He's trying to attack Too Cold Scorpio and Gabriel as well. What the hell is that? That guy is just a simple referee getting involved in a fight with these two like a wrestler. This is not right. Can somebody tell me what the hell is this? What the hell is this? Well, we're back here in the broadcast table. What the hell was that? The referee getting involved on that brawl. He got tired of trying to separate Too Cold and Gabriel. And he just lost his temper. And getting involved between those two like a wrestler. That's the damnest thing I've ever seen. Now we're gonna broadcast this via satellite, because Shagun has a message to deliver to AC3, but Shagun is... Whoa, such an incredible house that is. As you can see on the screen, is that Shagun's house? EC3. Do you recognize this house? I guess so. But now you see, after these 2 weeks, I finally came to the conclusion that you may have actually some kind of a good amount of money. But the thing is, can we actually call you a billionaire? I mean, don't get me wrong, this house, it looks incredible. This used to be your house back in the day. But it is still not enough to convince me that you are actually a billionaire. Because you may have spent a lot of millions in this house, by the looks of it, but not actually out of your pocket, I would say. You may have got some good amount of money to buy some good agreement, probably with your hunt, to arrange this house for you. But it is still not enough to convince me that you are actually a real-life billionaire more than just a gimmick. But guess what, EC3? I know you don't live in this house anymore, for some whatever reason. But I'm inviting you, EC3. Come. Come down here. Come and meet me here. Because I guess we're gonna have a pretty good fight later tonight. See you, fella.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Portugal, weighing in at 205 pounds, John Silva.
Guys, we have two of WWE's most exciting superstars ready to square off here.
And there's nothing quite like seeing two superstars settling it in the ring in one-on-one action, Michael.
From where I sit, he certainly seems more focused than perhaps I've ever seen him.
He's got one tall task ahead of him here, that's for sure.
Coming up here, guys, and I'm willing to bet this will be one we won't soon forget.
Totally agree, Michael. When you have two superstars as hungry as these two competing in the ring, you can bet it'll be memorable.
And Byron, I'd say he appears to be at the top of his game right now.
Well, he's gonna need to be if he wants to survive this match, that's for sure.
Both men enter this match with tidal waves of momentum, which set them on a collision course for this very moment. It's all or nothing, and these two men wouldn't have it any other way.
And this is one of those matches where it's hard to believe we get paid for this. Well, actually, it's hard to believe.
Looking for the quick pin. Now might be a good opportunity to fill our viewers in on Silva. It's anybody's game. He had him locked in tight, guys.
This could be it.
Whoa, he works his way out.
A bit of a Houdini job right there.
Just brings him down with authority there. And it looks like this one's going out to the floor. He's trying to mangle his face here. His chest may be black and blue after this. He's pressing all the right buttons now. Oh man, what a hit.
Knocked right off the apron.
Clobbers him with the axe handle.
I don't think this is where Daigle wants to be.
But he's very aware of who he's in there with and what he has to do to rebound.
He just has to make sure this doesn't get too out of hand for him. Sometimes, momentum has a way of permanently swinging one way. That's what he wants to avoid here.
Nicely done. Oh, the sledgehammer is just sickening to watch. The ref had no choice but to call the match.
Well, there you can see Tyson Kidd on his office with PG Golan once again. Alright, arrange me that woman. Yes, bye. Oh, what, Tyson, were you talking about some women on phone? Yes. Oh, there they are. Oh, look at these hot women. Yes, Peachy, and now that everything is controlled, Schleck is in jail. The securities are around my office door. If something goes out of hand... Oh, not again, Tyson. Oh, wait a minute. And now we have these beautiful women, these girls, for us all night long. I'm gonna give you plenty of them, BG. You can take care of them into your locker room as soon as I'm getting here, Orny, with these beautiful pieces of heart. Oh, lady. I guess tonight we're gonna have some hot action. Well, I want some of those too. We're back here in the broadcast table. Look at all of those hot women that Tyson Kidd has brought out. While we're here at backstage, I'm Joseph, and I'm making here an interview with none other than Bruce Bannister. Bruce, earlier tonight, you and Schleck, before Schleck got into jail, you have had a massive attack on Tyson Kidd with chair shots. How can you justify his behavior on putting Schleck on jail, your friend? Well, of course, Tyson Kidd is always coming up with his ideas. Now it seems like he's safe. He feels like he's safe because he has contracted a bunch of security losers to protect his office, and now he's even having a massive party with those women. Strip, what a massive party. I would call it a disgusting semen party. But guess what? Tyson Kidd, if you think you're in safe right now that you have securities around you, Schleck is in jail, and even you have the world champion BG Golan behind your back, but you just forgot about some crucial factor. It is not just the fact that Schleck at any moment in time could escape, and he actually can escape jail. But you just forgot about that I'm still on the arena. Tyson, It is just a matter of time until I catch you in the wrong moment and beat your ass once again, just like I did earlier tonight. I may see you next week, Tyson. Until that time, take care of yourself before you get wasted. Oh, look who's there. Oh, no, don't you tell me that is Jerry Lawler coming down the arena. What the hell does this guy want from me? This guy never learns that he's not welcome here. JR, calm down, Jim McKellett. You see, Jim, before you lose your temper once again, I had to come down this aisle to tell you what type of conversation I had with our general manager Tyson last week. Hey, you don't need to. I saw that on the screen and I beat your ass in the minutes after. So thank you. Go to home. You're not welcome here. Calm down, Jim. That's where you're wrong, you see. What you saw on that screen last week, before you lose your temper, was just a portion of my conversation with Tyson Kidd, because you don't seem to understand that I worked for this company and there was a reason why I was here on the first show. Now if the backup guys on backstage tell you what's going on here or not, that is not my business. But I'm actually part of this company just like you are, Jim McKelvey. So I have all of the rights to be here just like you. So when you say I'm not welcoming here, I guess that is only your perspective. And you, JR, you are just a traitor. Jim Ross, you and me, we used to commentate back in the 90s. We used to be best friends, and now you're there supporting Jim McKelvey and even agreeing with all of the bad things he says about me. I'm not even touching on that matter anymore. That's not the point, Jay. That's not the point, Jerry Lawler. Shut up, JR. Now I have to talk to Jim McKelvey. Now, Jim, it seems like you have committed a very bad action last week. Actually, 2 weeks in a row, because you have jumped after me. Consider the fact that I am working here. It seems like I'm gonna sue you for what you did to me. So does a $10,000 sound good to you? Hey, you bastard, I'm not gonna give you any damn money. You're not taking any money out of my pockets. You're a piece of garbage. And now Jim McKelvey coming down to the ring face to face with Jerry Lawler. Get out of here. By the way, what type of work are you doing? Those broadcast tables are full. They are full of people there doing their good job. You don't have a spot on those tables. So for what kind of job have Tyson contracted you? Because I cannot imagine any else you could have done. Besides the fact that your table work is not even that good. Because all you know to say on those tables, from all of your past work I have seen, all you got to say, all you know to say is, "What? What?" Like a stupid idiot, like a piece of garbage you are. And now Jerry Lawler slapping Jim McKelvey. Jim McKelvey jumping after Jerry Lawler here on the ring. Oh my god. What? What the hip? Well, these securities. Oh my god, they are trying to separate this as soon as possible, ASAP! Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're getting close to the final of this broadcast. We're actually very near to the final of this one. And it seems like we have Shagan around EC3's former house once again. Is he still waiting there for EC3? The show is almost over. EC3, it feels like you don't have the guts to come down here, right? I knew it. I always thought you were not the man to come and face me near your cutie former house. I thought this was sufficient to make you lose your temper. But it feels like I have to go further with this. Oh, Mr. Shagan, I'm receiving word here in the broadcast table that Mr. EC3 is not anywhere in the building because last week he suffered an injury during his match against Ted DiBiase on his nose cavity. Either way, he's just gonna be out for this week. Next week, he should come back. Ha! Oh, thanks there, Jim McCallett. You say an injury in his nose cavity. Doesn't that sound so suspicious? Doesn't that sound like a little excuse that he took out of a book that he read somewhere? An injury in a nose cavity. Do you know what type of injuries do I think he has on his nose cavity? Is that he's still waiting to give his nose another fix on those white lines. I can see that now. Perhaps his money has decreased because he said that he has let go of his old billionaire status. Oh, EC3. I don't know where you are at this point in time, but I get it. I'm gonna tell you that next week, I'm gonna come after you. If you don't find another excuse to tell us. Because in that case, so I'm gonna be forced to find you in your current house. Well, and this is strong words by Shagan. This is a warning. Seriously, EC3 got an injury on his nose cavity? Last week, nobody told me about that. Well, colleague Stevie Ray, I mean, I never heard that last week, but it feels like EC3 has told me via Tyson Kidd, so... he has told Tyson. That sounds like a little excuse to me. Well, either way, here comes Tyson Kidd speaking about the devil. Sorry, Shagan. Right there on the screen, how are ya? Now I have to take care of this show, and this time right now is for me, cause this show is getting to its final minutes tonight, and I'm gonna be forced to cut your promo. Sorry, Shagan. What the hell? Tyson Kidd is not even respecting his wrestlers anymore. Cutting Shagan's promo via satellite. He was cutting a promo on EC3, and what the hell is this? I'm not leaving tonight until I find out who are the owners of Ringside Wrestling. The network hasn't told me a damn thing. It seems like everybody knows things before I even know them. For God's sakes, I am the owner of this company. I should be the first one knowing those types of things. Jim McCallowitt, it feels like you don't know anything about it. And not anybody on the back has told me a damn thing. So who are the owners of Ringside Wrestling? I'm gonna grab my telephone now and call the network directly. Let's see what Wrestling News has to say about this. Now actually show the telephone. Show the telephone. Yeah. Show the telephone call on our screen, please. Thanks, producers. Hi. Yes, this is Mr. Tyson from PwC. Yes, I'm calling you out, network, because apparently everybody knows that there is a new brand being featured to my company. Ooh, yeah. So how can I not know who are the owners of a brand being broadcast on my own show? What? I'm gonna find it right now. What the hell are you talking about? Wasn't it supposed to start next week? Right now, you're stealing minutes of my own show without even telling me a damn thing in time. What the hell? Here he comes. What the hell is that? Tony Schiavone and Paul Heyman. They are taking they are telling Jim McElwain and Stevie Ray to leave the broadcast table. Now it is our time. Our time? What do you mean? Jim, we are the broadcast colleagues, the broadcast commentators for Ringside Wrestling Show. So these last 10 to 15 minutes are ours. Well, and it feels like Jim Ross, I'm the only one who is still in this broadcast table, actually from PwC. Now I'm accompanied by Tony Schiavone and Paul Heyman, who apparently are the commentators for Ringside Wrestling. Well, let's start things here tonight. Okay, those two are the commentators, but who are the freaking owners? I'm losing my mind now. What the hell is that? What the? Trish Stratus is one of the owners, one of the biggest Tyson Kidd's enemies of all time. Tyson is still speechlessly. He's still speechless here. And this is not all, Tyson. This is not all. Look at who is doing work with me. You're gonna love this one. What the? Kyo, Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens and Trish Stratus are the owners of Ringside Wrestling. Is this? How can this even be? Tyson Kidd is still speechless about this. Yeah, he's speechless, GR. But now let's kick off this thing with our match. This last 10 to 15 minutes are ours. And it's gonna be Ringside Wrestling Superstars Albert facing Moises, who, by the way, is a former PwC star on that ring. Let's start this thing off. Seriously, you're topping our main event with this type of match. Well, I'm out of here. Well, JR has left as well. Now we are in Ringside Wrestling time. Let's do this.
Something tells me we're not going to see too much dancing out of Albert here tonight.
I don't think I remember the last time he looked this motivated, guys.
That's a scary thought, Cole. Even before tonight, I don't think I've seen too many superstars more motivated than him.
For this one.
So am I, Michael. I've been looking forward to this match for a long, long time.
I gotta say, guys, he doesn't appear to be in the mood here tonight.
He's not the only one, Cole. I gotta say, I'm not really in the mood to be sitting next to you two. But hey, we do what we have to do.
This should be an incredible matchup. I mean, both men have extensive offensive repertoires, lasting endurance, and an insatiable appetite to be number one.
Oh man, this is gonna be great.
And we're underway with what many are calling the most anticipated match of the night. Drops him with a bulldog.
He's simply reminding him that he's here.
Let's take a moment to discuss Morris.
So tell us, oh wise one, what's he got to do to win here tonight?
It's still early, but I really like his chances here tonight. He certainly looks more focused than I remember seeing him in recent weeks.
But wow, these fans are in for a real treat here. I know that for sure.
Toss to the outside.
Albert's starting to look a little off his game.
I fully expect him to bounce back, though. This is the type of one-on-one atmosphere where he thrives.
Sure, he's taking some punishment here, but given how much he prefers to be on the outside of the ring, he can very well change the outlook of the match with one shot.
This is all part of the process, guys. He knew he would take on some offense here tonight. He just has to make sure he keeps it to a minimum.
He's got to hurry if he doesn't want to get counted out here.
Time's certainly not on his side, Michael.
Oh, and a terrific reversal by Albert.
Eight.
A high-risk maneuver in the works from that top turnbuckle. Incredible!
One.
I don't think this is the time for Albert to be showing off.
Move coming.
Oh man, talk about a hard landing.
When his strikes land, you can feel it in the first few rows.
Oh no.
He lands the arm drag.
Physical condition I've ever seen him in.
He might have it.
He's just so dominant.
You have to like his chances here.
Reverses that one.
Perfect form on that tackle.
Made him pay there.
Oh, and he's one step ahead on that one.
What a clothesline.
And that one grounds him. I didn't realize he had such a glass jaw.
Incoming.
He is a one-man gang in there.
Two. Three.
He's inflicting some serious pain here.
He misses on that one.
Were his eyes even open?
Four. Five.
What athleticism.
Six.
Cutting it close here, guys.
What a coward. He's trying to get himself counted out, Cole.
Albert's not someone to sleep on.
He's in a tough spot here, Corey.
And if he doesn't get up, it's going to get a lot tougher.
Two. Three.
I just can't get over the physicality of this match. It has been absolutely brutal. Perfectly timed slam.
Albert looks absolutely unstoppable right now.
He's not going to like this. On Albert, so strong. Powerful with a sit out power bomb.
What a comeback.
You can put this one in the bank. Victory here tonight.
Wow, he absolutely manhandled him there toward the end.
Folks, we just saw one.